So in this exercise from the book page 720, we are going to create a new wire form. Essentially, we are going to make like the wire coil with both the loop and helical wire. The trick will be to make the loop path for a sweep. So we start a new file, ANSI. And we are going to place on a top plane, we are going to place a sketch. And we will first make a circle, which will be a 2 inches diameter. And the circle of a 2 inches diameter. And that circle we are going to use to define our helix for the first profile. So the helix that we are going to define will be of the constant pitch with 1/8 inch of the pitch, 8 revolutions, what means 1 inch high, and start angle will be at 0 and clockwise direction. So it's insert, curve, helix spiral. Pitch will be in this case 1/8 of the inch, and this will be a constant pitch. Number of revolutions are going to be at 8, and it will be a clockwise with a starting angle of 0. And I'm going to make my sketch one invisible. Actually, sketch one, I'm going to hide. Okay, so here is my helix. Now, I can actually do something here. I can create the sketch profile, as well as I may want to use something else. I can also use just a sketch circle. Let's create a sketch profile. And the plane on which we are going to create the sketch profile will be the right plane. And I'm going to make somewhere on a right plane circle. And I'm going to add the circle lower quadrant point and helix. If I choose the helix, actually, if I choose the helix, and if I choose the circle, I want to add the circle lower quadrant point. So let's see. That's my circle lower quadrant point. So if I choose that point and if I choose the circle, going to create a relationship which will be a pierce, and I'm going to dimension that circle to be a 0.120. So I'm also going to, if I look straight onto that circle, I'm going to create horizontal and vertical center line, which I'm going to use later. So from quadrant to quadrant points. Now, I'm going to create a sweep feature, not as a surface, but as a feature, which will sweep this object. So if I go to the sweep, sketch two, and the path is my center line. And here is my first wire. That's my helical wire wound. Now, I'm going to create a two offset planes to actually construct a geometry which I will use to make the hoop wires. First offset plane will be 1.150 of the top vertical. So I'm going to choose the top plane, I'm going to insert reference geometry plane, and the offset will be 1.15. Click OK. That's my first offset plane. Now, I'm going to make another offset plane, and I will need to flip the dimensions. So, because the new offset plane will be for 0.045 under the top reference plane. So, I'm going to choose the top plane. Going again to insert reference geometry plane. This distance will be 0.045, and because I want it to be the under, I'm going to flip it over so that it is under. So if I click on the flip offset, the offset will go in opposite direction. Okay. I will choose my plane one, my first offset plane that I have created, and I'm going to place a sketch of it. And I'm going to create the two circles, which will be centered around the origins. So the center point will be coincidental with the origin. And the two circles diameter, the inner one is going to be 1.750, and the outer one is going to be a 2.250. And I'm going to choose both circles and convert them to be for construction only, because I'm just going to use them. So I will click on the box for construction only, because I will just going to use them to create my loop, my hoop, actually hoop or loop for the path for my next sweep, for the loop sweep. So we are going to make the two lines, vertical line, actually ensure that both ends of the line are coincident with the upper quadrant points of the two circles. So I'm going to make a vertical line. Again, that line is going to be regular line, and it will be from the one quadrant point to another quadrant point, and I'm going to press an escape. So that's the line that I'm going to be arraying. Now I'm going to choose that line, and I'm going to use the circular pattern, circular sketch pattern in the content of the sketch. And I'm going to put just 32 number of instances, and that will define my 32 loops. Okay. We need to create the 3 points. Why this pattern is underdefined? Who can tell me what is not defining this pattern? What is not defining this pattern is the orientation in a space. If I choose any of the 2 points which are opposite, and if I choose the midpoint, and if I click them to be a horizontal, these two horizontal, and then if I choose the third point, and if I made them all three to be horizontal, look what will happen. Now that wheel is fixed, that it cannot really rotate on that plane, so this is now fully defined. Now, if we select everything, we can convert this to a construction geometry. So I will choose everything, and I'm going to click that this is for a construction box, and click for construction, and click OK. And as you can see now, we have this everything for a construction. Now I'm going to exit this sketch, and I'm going to create a derived sketch on the bottom plane, on the plane tool. And I'm going to kind of, and I'm going to add collinear relationship between the horizontal line on the right and on the front plane, as you will see it now. And then we are going to create a 3D sketch which will connect the points. Add the sketch fillet, and we are going then to do our sweep. So how we create the derived sketch? Well, first we start a new sketch on the plane. Or the easier way will be that we just hold the control key to choose. We choose the sketch tree, and then we go to the insert. Derived sketch. Let's get the derived sketch part. Insert. I have control and I have a plane tool and I have a sketch and I press down control and sketch tree. So I need to choose both plane and the sketch. And now I can insert. Derived sketch. And look, I have now sketch 3 derived. If I look into the derived sketch, it's blue. However, I can now completely get this sketch aligned. If I choose these 2 points and I'm going to see that the central point to be a coincidental, and I'm going to choose going to choose the one of the point, one of the line on the derived sketch. Let's say this one. And I'm going to press Control and choose the front plane. And I'm going to make those two to be collinear and that will orient my sketch. And the sketch is now oriented and black. And I'm going to exit the sketch. All entities are defined. Now I have these two sketches and I need to create a hoop. I will need to create the hoop. And to do that, I can hide my sweep feature. So to make it easier, I right-click on a sweep feature and I press on hide. And I'm also going to hide the helix. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a 3D sketch. And I'm going to choose the line from arbitrary one on the endpoints on top and connect it to one on the endpoints at the bottom. And then we are going kind of to go through that thing. So let's say that I start 3D sketch and I choose the line at one points at the top. And we go to the one endpoints at the bottom. And now are going to snap. Very important is to snap from here to here. And then we go to the bottom. And then we go to the left. Please snap. Then we go to the top. And we kind of wind. Okay, these two need to snap. If they don't snap, see what happened. If they don't snap, doesn't work. So now again. We go from this snap object to this one, 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 a little bit. Okay, something didn't snap here. This is what didn't snap. And so on, we continue winding this helix until we come to the end. Careful that it snap at the right place. If you see something blue, please immediately snap it because it gets very confusing. We continue drawing the line in a 3D sketch.
Would you be able to use circular patterns?
We can try to, however, when I tried last time, it didn't work out because it need to, it somehow the tolerances does not let you. What we can try, I think that there is some numerical problem that will prevent us from doing that. Difficult to see it sometimes. Moment you see undefined lines, please click immediately and correct. So we are continuing. Again, we connect those coincidental, and we are almost there. And here we now need to be especially careful about closing this steel. Okay, this one is not working here, this needs to be coincidental. And the last two lines that we need to pull will be a line from here to here, here to here, and back. And now we do have our helical structure, our hoop structure completely done. So the hoop structure for the path is done. Now, what we need to do, we will sketch the stat fillet. We will now need to add the sketch fillets. And the sketch fillets are for a 120. And then we are going to do the boss sweep. So to do the sketch fillet, we will click on a fillet. And we will put 0.12. And now we need to really choose at all of the intersections. Or what we can do, we can try to add everything. Entities to fillets, everything. Let's see why this is not filleting. It should be a sketch fillet in a 3D sketch mode. Edit sketch. And this should be a fillet. Yeah, because they are not coplanar, you cannot choose all of them at the same time. That's the problem. So that's the 120. So which will take us now a little bit longer to choose all of the lines. Be filleted. Once we fillet everything, we will be ready to do the sweep. So we learned something new. We can't choose non-coplanar curves for the fillets in the same fillet in a 3D sketch mode. And if we by accident close command, we just reopen it again. Very important for this sweep to work is that all lines be all the corners be filled properly. What will take us some time to do here. In order not to get confused, it's best like to go and to fillet them in the same series as we did it for hooping. We are still filleting it. Careful that we do it in order, otherwise it is going to be very messy to catch where we have an error. are almost done. And the last hoop. Now, as we are finishing the hoop, we don't really need to create a new circular profile, because this one is going to be a centered, will be a circular profile centered around the path that we have just created. So to do this, we are going to create the three balls, and we are going to put the features, sweeped balls, circular profile, and then I click on the radio button circular profile, and the diameter will be 0.08 inches, and the path, I'm going to choose the 3D sketch one. And look what happened. I have my closed sketch done. Here is my hoop wind. And now I'm going to make visible my previous wind by right-clicking and showing it. And here is my entire coil completed. Okay, so now this concludes the demonstration, and it's up to you to complete your coil. That's all for today.